rate of species extinction. An answer to that is evaluation, development of conservation strategies, implementation, and monitoring. The first two involves concepts of molecular biology, examples of which are molecular phylogenetics and DNA barcoding. With this, scientists can strategically allocate conservation efforts. And in the present time, both can be done simultaneously, like in our study entitled Molecular Phylogeny and DNA Barcoding of the Genus Argostema, including an account of a new species and variety from Octagon or Italian Dora. So to better appreciate the role of molecular biology in biodiversity conservation, we focus on the genus Argostema wallich, which is characterized as inconspicuous, nymphophytic, delicate herbs, and with an estimate of 220 species worldwide. According to the 2014 IUCN National Red List, some of the foreign Argostema were considered as vulnerable species. Taking this into consideration, there is an urgent call for us to conserve and study these species, knowing that Philippines is home only to 9 species. Furthermore, Argostema are all to be protected since they possess various importance, one of which is its ecological role as bioindicator for forest pollution, as Argostema are commonly found associated with cryptogams such as small ferns and moss, and they only thrive in good quality forests. Furthermore, comprehensive surveys of Argostema type localities reveal that rare plant taxa, such as Rhodesia, could also be found in those areas, which imply that protection of Argostema species and their habitat will consequently protect other species, making it qualify as a potential umbrella species for biodiversity conservation. In addition, recent studies reveal that foreign Argostema species possess great medicinal importance for having antibacterial, antibiotic, and antibiotic activities, as proven by various journal publications. Moving on with the taxonomy of Argostema, since its establishment in 1832 by Wallich, there's been no comprehensive taxonomic treatment except that in Borneo and Thailand. And previous molecular studies involve only limited taxon sampling. And the most recent molecular phylogeny of Argostema, done by Ryden et al. In 2009, there was no inclusion of Philippine Argostema species. So now, what is the problem with our Philippine Argostema? First of all, it is systematically underrated, as there was no molecular and morphology-based systematics done for the genus. Because of its taxonomic difficulty brought about by the apparent morphological homogeneity within its members. So to resolve the problematic status of Philippine Argostema, 3 markers were used, 2 coming from the thoracic DNA, which is the TRNF region, which is commonly used at lower taxonomic levels. Another one is the RPS16 intron, which is used at the family level and below. And one coming from the nuclear DNA, the internal transcribed spacer, which is now gaining popularity because of its high universality. Our study has the following objectives. First is to identify the collected Argostema samples using comprehensive morphological assessment. Second, confirm their phylogenetic position using combined IDS, RPS16, and TRNF datasets. And lastly, evaluate the best barcoding loci among the markers used. So for an overview of our research methodology, it involves a preliminary step of taxon sampling done in various collection sites. The collected samples were subjected to morphological study involving herbarium sheet preparations and microscope observation, and molecular study involving DNA sequence, DNA extractions, amplification, purification, and sequencing. The results were gathered for data analysis, and the subsequent taxonomic treatment were based on the combined morphomolecular analysis. So for the results, 14 Argostema samples were collected from the 8 sites representing the 3 main regions of the Philippines, Belida, Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. And out of the 14 Argostema samples, 7 species were identified after comprehensive morphological assessment and comparison with type specimens and chromosomes. And for the phylogenetic position of Philippine Argostema, the generated majority group consensus tree elucidated its monophyly, with a posterior probability of 1. Similar to the study conducted by Riding et al. In 2009. Also, a separate name was formed for the Philippine Ergostema, shaded in blue, and also with a high support. The intergenetic groupings proposed by Bremer in 1989 were also validated by the formation of cytokeratinous group, shaded in red, and parvifolium group, shaded in yellow. After meticulous investigation, one of our materials exhibited distinctness from the rest of the Ergostema species, with Ergostema sudaniflorum and Ergostema bryophyllum as its closely related species. Differences were seen in their habit, stem, leaf structures, characteristics of inflorescence, calyx lobes, and corolla lobes. Thus, we proposed a novel species, Ergostema sisinduensis aranas Bacani and Alejandro Espino, with the following distinguishing features. Aside from comprehensive morphological description, a botanical description was provided to facilitate its identification. The proposed conservation status for Ergostema sisinduensis is sadly critically endangered, based on the IUCN red list for threatened species. Another interesting finding was inferred from morphological assessment of one Ergostema isolate, which is found to be closely related with Ergostema sudaniflorum. Differences were only seen on their leaf structures and a characteristic of inflorescence. These characters are not strong enough to propose a new species. Thus, we propose a variety, Ergostema sudaniflorum, variety Jacinto, natural of Alejandro Espino, with the following distinguishing features and its botanical illustration. So, the conservation status proposed for the variety is endangered, again, basing it on the IUCN red list category. For the DEM coding, 5 Philippine Ergostema and 1 foreign Ergostema were used to evaluate the best barcoding loci among IES, RPS16, and DRNNF on the basis of universality, discriminatory power, and resolution of species. In terms of universality, all 3 barcoding loci performed well. However, in contrast with the RPS16 and DRNNF, IES gave the highest percentage for informative and variable and proximally informative sites, despite it having the shortest length of base pairs. So in terms of its discriminatory power, still, IES gave the highest percentage for mean interspecific divergence, with 7.9%. On the other hand, all 3 barcoding loci performed species discrimination for mean interspecific divergence. So to further evaluate the effectiveness of these 3 barcoding loci for species discrimination, maximum likelihood 3 was generated for each loci. And still, IES gave the highest sequence for species, highest percentage for species resolution with 80%, followed by RPS16 with 50% and DRNNF with 16.67%. Thus, we proposed in our study that IDS is the best locus to use for discrimination of the species because of its high universality, discriminatory power, and resolution of species. Philippine Ergostema is monophyletic, followed monophyletic with validated intergenetic groupings. And in our study, IDS is the best performing marker for the genus, and a combined IDS RPS16 is proposed for its discrimination. And a new species and variety of Ergostema are proposed for the Philippines biodiversity. With the discovery of suitable barcodes and its endemicity asserted, we can now assess the economic and medicinal properties of this genus. So I am now inviting the pharmacist and biochemist present here to explore our very own endemic species. And our studies were able to generate 2 papers for publication. The first one was submitted in Phytotaxa and is in interview status, and the other one is in preparation. So I would like to thank the following organizations for helping us accomplish our study: the RCNAS, NAPBG, and the DOSDPC. Thank you for listening, and I am now open for your